guys. I know it's dark, but give me a second here. I just farted. FedEx just ran. I hate FedEx because they don't, like, ring the doorbell when they leave something at it. But luckily, their notification system, when they text you for a delivery, is almost instantaneous. Whereas UPS will ring the doorbell. But their, like, text when you have gotten your delivery to say that it's been delivered is, like, 10 minutes behind or something. So, you know, if you have shifty neighbors, you want to get to it right away. Anyway, the rug is here. I haven't made my bed today, but I did last night before I went to bed. I cleaned up this whole area. I need to move my chair. I got some linen there that needs to be washed, but in a minute, you'll see the rug. Oh, and there it is. Hey. Ooh, it's a nice pattern. It's actually lighter than the picture in Amazon, but I really dig it. I'm getting rid of the old, nightstand here. This actually used to be part of a desk, and there was a whole other side of it that came out that you'd set at, and I cut it off, painted it, but I'm just so tired of it at this point. I've had it for 15 years. It's been through 3 or 4 different revisions, and I'm tired of it, so I'm going to get rid of that and put a beautiful, like, glass console table right here with a nice lamp on it. And it'll be really pretty. It's got this great pattern on it, but it looks kind of old. It looks like it's faded. See in spots right there, there's big holes. I like it. I'm out of breath because, God, the plastic was a bitch to get off of there.
That is done. So now I gotta go throw all this plastic away that it was wrapped in. It's so nice outside. The windows are open. I took one of the girls out, or I took Sookie out on her leash. The windows are open. There's a nice breeze. It's a little cool. It'll probably get really cooler like around 5 or 6 when the sun starts to go down a little bit more. So really, I think all I have to get is that console table and another lamp and one more rug, the purple rug that I always talk about right where I'm sitting here over near the window. And that'll be it. There'll be 2 rugs in here, which is just right. I could go with just one, but I kind of want 2 to round out the look. Here we go. Actually, there's not a lot of work for me to do today because of what I do. There's a system that's down that I can't work on right now. It won't be up till around 6. So there's going to be a push for that. I think I'm going to take it easy for just a little bit. Record a little bit of vinyl for about an hour or something. And then go try to do something else. It's just kind of a weird forced day off in a way because of that. But I will be busier this evening, actually. It's kind of a flipped schedule. Hope your Tuesday's going well.
Is this thing on?
Hey, don't be touching my shit, man.
Brand new TV, what are we stuck watching? Frickin' by such an asshole.
You're hateful.
That's a long video.
It's not too long.
7 minutes. What are you looking at me for? What are you looking at me?
Can you rub the top of my foot, please? This is the one that's been hurting. It's hurt for 2 weeks. No, it's just the top of the foot. It's almost like I pulled a muscle on the whole top of the foot.
Shut up, will you? Free foot rub. Would you rub my back? No, not quite that way. No, sort of when you do
well,
this.
Well, but you
no,
want no, it in the right. Left hand. Oh, no, no, you're, no, no. Do you have that back scratch over there? Oh, can you just scratch my back to the left? Oh, I'm sorry, my other left.
5 seconds.
I would have scratched as long as you wanted. You pulled away. We do. Oh, and I found the back scratcher. It's in my room on my bookshelf.
Well, hopefully it'll go scratch later.
I'm scratching right now. It's just across the top of the foot. Almost like someone dropped something on it. That's it. Oh, Daddy.
Oh, Daddy.
Oh, it's David Muir.
David Muir. The ghost of Mr. Muir.
I wouldn't mind him haunting my holes.
You're just disgusting.
We just finished dinner. I haven't done a lot of vlogging today. It's been a little busy, actually. I had to make this video for a blog that I run. Yesterday, the blog I run, the smartphone app that's related to it, was down all day. For maintenance. And it came back up around 6 o'clock just after Brian got home. We quickly got to work, you know, earning points because that's sometimes how we get some free stuff. The blog I run was just bombarded with questions. And I actually turned off the ask feature overnight and turned it back on today. So it's just been a busy day. I had to make this video and edit it because something related to that. So, but we had a really good dinner. Dinner was good, right? It was linguine pasta with, instead of putting red sauce on it, I learned this from probably Ina Garten, But if you go to a store like Fresh Market, if you get truffle butter, there's dark truffle butter and light truffle butter. Fix about a half a pound of pasta, then toss this butter into it. And, you know, it's made with truffles.
And bacon.
Well, and I did bacon. I actually had some bacon that I diced up and then rendered all the fat out of it and made it real crispy and drained it on a paper towel. Brian's mocking me. And then after I cooked the linguine really al dente, I put the butter in the pan with the pasta and stirred it up and let it melt. And then I swished a little bit of pasta water. I saved some pasta water. I swished some pasta water in it. And it just makes this really thick kind of starchy sauce. And the butter has a little bit of salt in it. And it's got that mushroom kind of flavor to it. Because that's what truffles do. Mm-hmm. And I'm just going to ignore Brian. But it's really good. And then you put the bacon in there. It's really rich. It's kind of one of those things that, you know, you're only going to have one bowl of it. And it's really rich. Because it's butter. It's truffle butter. But oh my God, it's good. And little shredded cheese on top. So... Ooh, it was rich, though. You know, Brian, you have been spoiled this week because you've had dinner cooked for you every single night. Pork roast on Monday. Yesterday were chicken thighs wrapped in bacon. And then tonight you had white truffle butter pasta.
So?
And I didn't even get 3 minutes of a foot rub. You see how he treats me?
3 minutes and 3 seconds. There you go.
That was really good, whatever you do with your left hand on top. I don't know what it is. I haven't dropped anything on it, but it really feels like I've dropped something heavy on it. It's that. It feels like a bruise. Isn't it weird?
Somebody sneaking in your room at night and banging a bowling ball on your foot.
I've got a ghost that's abusing me. I guess my tailbone's been hurting too.
Yeah. Ew. And now, a moment with Ernest in the bathroom. That was a moment with Ernest in the bathroom.
It's gonna be May. Well, happy Thursday. Ooh, I've just been yawning. My eyes are watery. And yes, I have on the same shirt as yesterday. So the doorbell just rang, and we never have visitors, so it had to be the mail. You know what? There's a squirrel over. We have a family of squirrels that hang out here, and we feed them nuts in the afternoon. And one of them is all over a window this morning, and it's making Phoebe crazy. Anyway, when the doorbell rang, it's usually because it's mail or delivery. I had recently ordered 3 records that I had as a kid, and I've never been able to find them anywhere. And there's a site called Discogs, DISCOGS.com, and it's a great place. I actually use it to catalog my collection of vinyl. You can actually look up the exact record you have. I mean, they have everything on that site. And you can look up the exact record that you have, you know, the exact release by the UPC code or the catalog number or something like that, and then add it to your collection. And you can keep track. And, you know, people can, if you want, you can send them a link to the collection to look at and see what you own and everything. And it's also a marketplace, so you can buy and sell vinyl there. Well, I had some albums as kids, those K-Tel collections. I remember my mom bought me one at Target, but there were a couple other compilations that I had, and I've never been able to find them. I've looked in record stores, and, you know, the Last Vestige that we go to has such great stuff, never been able to find these. So I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to go on Discogs and spend about $25. That's my limit. And I found the 3 records that I had. One is called K-Tel Full Tilt. Oh, there was the record Exotica for Martin Denny. But the other one, you remember Ronco and what's the guy's name that runs Ronco? Ron Popeil, that's it. I had to look it up. Ron Popeil. So Ronco came out with all kinds of funky products, right? They were putting records out for a little while, and I ordered one. And years ago, I had looked up the track listing of this. And, you know, was able to build the track list in iTunes, so I could still listen to the record, but I didn't own the physical copy. Well, today, it showed up, and it's called Solid Gold. Ronco presents Solid Gold, featuring million-selling hits by original artists. Andrew Gold, Jennifer Warrens, Hot Chocolate, Thelma Houston, Barry Manilow, Marvin Gaye, Stephen Bishop, Rolls Royce, all kinds of great stuff on there. And of course, on the back, they're selling the Ronco, what is it, the Ronco record vacuum? Because, you know, there's a million ways to clean your record, and apparently they had ones. These are based out of Grove Village, Illinois. So if you live in Illinois or near Grove Village, you know where that's at. Oh, sorry, Elk Grove Village. My thumb was over it. Elk Grove Village, Illinois. Let me know in the comments if you're from that area. And I'm going to look you up to prove it. So don't lie to me. And then this Chicago, Illinois is where you would send $10.88 check or money order, no CODs, to Chicago, plus $1 for postage and handling, and add applicable sales tax for the record vacuum. So, but this is the record I had, so it's really surreal owning this. I'm 47 years old, and I had this when I was a kid. I can't wait for the KTEL album to show up. You'll probably hear about that. Look for it on Instagram. I've been kind of cataloging some of the stuff I recorded lately. If you go to Instagram, slash Ernest L. Sewell 4, the number 4, you'll find me. There's also a link right down below to my Instagram of Brian. Brian doesn't Instagram very much. Y'all should message him and tell him he should Instagram pictures more. I've tried to get him to do it, but he seems disinterested in it. So y'all should tell him he should Instagram more. I'm happy as a clam right now. Brian's cooking out burgers tonight on a grill because it's just such a beautiful day already. But I'm going to make my grandma's homemade potato salad, and I'm going to show you how I do that right now. Should be some in there, isn't there? Brian's manning the grill tonight. We're having burgers, and I am ready. Grill time. Ooh, look at that. Burgers and corn. What's that up there?
It's your pineapple.
Mm-hmm. Red Robin has this burger called the Bonsai Burger that's like this really sweet barbecue sauce, and then it's got pineapple. It's really good, so I'm kind of trying that tonight. But Brian picked up some burgers the other day, and he loves corn on the cob. I always have a fear of my teeth coming out. We decided not to warm up the oven because the whole point was to cook outside, not turn anything on, even though we had a few fries and onion rings. You see that pathetic soul right there? Phoebe! Yes. Oh my God, there's a fire! Oh boy, that melted fast. So much better than that other grill we had, which is right there. We gotta get rid of it. I'm not going to have two of everything around here. So yeah, we are ready to eat some dinner. I will take those. You sure you don't want to just pile them up on here? All right. Brian does love him some corn. But I always have a fear of my teeth popping out. I don't know why, but... All right, well, let's gather this stuff up so it doesn't blow everywhere. Let's get in here and get to eating. Hey everyone, it is 11:40 and I'm recording vinyl. Janet, Mrs. Jackson, if you're nasty. Brian went to bed about an hour ago. It wasn't actually a little over an hour ago. He wasn't feeling too well. Hope he wakes up okay. But he bought a bunch of Robitussin and cough drops and stuff when he came home. He said a lot of people at work were coughing, so hopefully he doesn't wake up worse tomorrow or it spreads to moi. But it was a little early for me to go to bed, so I've just been plowing through some vinyl recordings tonight. I may keep going. I'm doing a bunch of singles. I'm going to keep going till midnight, and then I'm still trying to catch up on R&B Divas and something else. Oh, I need to watch Arrow. That's what it is. I still got to catch up on Gotham. Do you watch Gotham? I'm thinking about giving up on it. I don't know if I'm going to stick with it or not. But that's about it. I had a great dinner. Dinner was really good. It was supposed to be a beautiful week, so who knows what could happen. Gosh, other than that, there's not a lot going on. Thanks for watching the video. If you made it this far, give it a thumbs up. Over here on your right, click the thumbs up button so we know that you got this far. Over here to the left, you can click the subscribe button. We do new vlogs every Tuesday and Friday. Every other Sunday is a challenge video. Every other Monday is a commentary video. Sunday, we're actually going to see The Avengers, Age of Ultron. I got us IMAX 3D tickets. Brian and I and Cheryl are going. That will be super fun. And we don't go to a lot of IMAX 3D because it's too expensive for us. You know, we're just kind of cheap that way. But we're looking forward to this one. So you're obviously going to hear about that when it happens. So everybody have a great weekend, and we will see you on Tuesday. I forget what's coming up this Sunday or Monday, if it's a commentary or I think it's a challenge video. But it'll probably go up in the afternoon because the movie is at 11:30 in the morning. I'll be back home that afternoon to upload it then. So anyway, have a great weekend. Thank you very much for watching. Thumbs up, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. All right, thanks for watching. Bye. This was our old street, Westerlo Street, where this was my first real apartment. And actually, this row of brownstones here used to be a lot prettier and brighter, and that was always in the apartment guide magazine. This was our old place, 73. This was my first apartment.